there is not even one single verse that says God the Son or God the Word, not only from Jesus' words, but from anyone's words in the whole Bible. Although our debate is from Jesus' words, where did Jesus claim to be God? But no problem. The answer is obvious. There is only one true God, and this God is the Father. God the Father alone. And this is what Jesus declared in John 17:3. Question number 7. Where did Jesus say, I am the second God in Trinity? Nowhere. Even in the whole Bible, we will never find one single verse that says that Father and Son and Holy Ghost, those three are one. Not even one single verse. I have more than 30 Bible translations in English and in Arabic. They don't contain such verse. Even the original scriptures, this is the source, doesn't contain even one verse that says the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, those three are one. But maybe our guest, MBI, in his Bible, he has such verse. I would like to see it. Those questions I ask, they simply show that the belief of Christians is inconsistent with their own Bible and inconsistent with what Jesus said, but actually contradicts his words. So Christians have only one way to escape this. There is only one hope. There is only one solution. Our dear guest MBI used it already many times. There is only one solution. What is the solution? God at same time. So I ask, simple question. Jesus spoke openly and in secret didn't say anything. Where did Jesus, who spoke openly and in secret didn't say anything, claim to have two natures, or say that he is complete man and complete God at same time? We can find he clearly said he is a man. Our dear guest said he didn't say he is a man, but he said, where? In John 8:40. But now you seek to kill me, a man that has told you the truth, which I have heard of God. Is another one, someone else. And by the way, God is not a man due to the Bible. In Hosea 11:19, for I am God and not man. In Numbers 23:19, God is not a man, nor a son of a man. Jesus said he is a prophet. Our dear guest said, no, he didn't say he is a man. He didn't say he is a prophet, but he said he is a prophet. Four verses. Matthew 13:57, and they were offended at him, but Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, save in his own country and in his own house. In Mark 6:4, he said he is a prophet. In Luke 4:24 and Mark 6:4, he is a prophet. In Luke 13:33, nevertheless I must walk today and tomorrow and the day following, for it cannot be that a prophet perish out of Jerusalem. Now, to finish this claim, once for all, prepare yourself for this shock. In Luke 22, verses 43-44, and there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. Didn't Jesus have God in him? Why didn't the God side strengthen Jesus? Why did Jesus depend on an identity outside the body? He should have dependent on his God nature, right? Or you will say the spirit in Jesus has no strength. I don't know. So Jesus spoke openly and in secret didn't say anything. He declared the Father to be the only true God. He declared himself as a man and prophet and never said he had two natures. Jesus says in Matthew 15:9, but in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. Case closed. Actually, I wonder when Jesus will be God. Simple question. When he will be God? In the Old Testament, his name is not even mentioned. And actually, due to the Jews, the owners of the Old Testament, by the way, Jesus in the Old Testament is nobody. And during Jesus' life on earth, he was not God. But the only true God is the Father alone. We read in Mark 12:28-32, and one of the scribes came and having heard them reasoning together, and perceiving that he had answered them well, asked him, which is the first commandment of all? And Jesus answered him, the first of all commandment is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord the God with all the heart and with all the soul and with all the mind and with all the strength. This is the first commandment. And the scribe said unto him, well, Master, thou hast said the truth, Jesus said the truth, for there is one God and there is none other but He. Jesus standing in front of him, and the scribe says that there is no God but He, not Jesus. Talking about God, again I ask, when Jesus will be God? After Judgment Day maybe? Let's read Corinthians 1 verses 15-28. And when all things shall be subdued unto him, then shall the Son also himself be subject unto him that put all things under him, that God may be all in all. Jesus, when he will be God? The only reasonable answer to when Jesus will be God is when pigs will fly, or in Arabic, fil mashmash. Do you believe in Jesus because he did miracles, so you assume that he is God? Actually, miracles of Jesus is evidence that he is not God, because simply God don't do miracles, because there is nothing that God cannot do. But miracles is given to prophets by power of God to support them in delivering the message. For example, what is the strongest miracle done by Jesus? And you, our dear guest, mentioned this miracle. Most Christians would say raising the dead. We can read the story when Jesus raised Lazarus from death. Jesus came and found people gathered because someone died. Imagine, Jesus didn't knew who died. And when he knew that it is Lazarus whom he loves, Jesus wept. John 11:35. Jesus wept. As far as I know, if any man dies, he go back to his creator. So if Jesus is God, this means Lazarus went up to Jesus. So why Jesus were groaning and weeping? Not only this, didn't he knew that he will raise him? Didn't he knew that he have the power to raise him? Answer from the context of this story is obvious. He didn't know. That's why after he was shocked and wept and groaned, he began to pray to the Father, the only true God. In John 11:41 we can read, John 11:41. Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid, and Jesus lifted up his eyes to the God in heaven and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. In next verse, John 11:42, we find that Jesus simply were given miracles same like all prophets, as evidence to crowds, to people, that he is a prophet and messenger of God. Read John 11:42, read. And I knew that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. He said this in order that people understand that he is a messenger. It is not him who is doing this. Further evidences from Jesus' words. John 5:36. But I have greater witness than that of John. For the works which the Father has given me to finish, the same works that I do. I will take my additional time, Brother Ibn Kathir, okay? That I do bear witness of me, that the Father has sent me. Also we read in Luke 11:20. But if I, with the finger of God, cast out devils, with the finger of God, no doubt the kingdom of God is come upon you. The Bible tells us in Matthew 24:24 that miracles is not evidence for divinity or prophethood. The Bible says, Matthew 24:24, for there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, in so much that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect. You cannot use the miracles and assume that Jesus is God. Although, and Jesus didn't do it by his own. It was given to him by the power of God. So miracles means nothing. Any false prophet Christ can make them. Peter, may peace be upon him, the disciple of Jesus, who lived beside him, says in Acts 2:22, you men of Israel, hear this word, Jesus of Nazareth, a man. Jesus said he is a man. Peter says he is a man. Approved of God among you by miracles and wonders and signs, which God did by him in midst of you, as you yourself also know. Usually Christians say Jesus did this or did that, and they begin to build assumptions that what he did means he is God. While Jesus, who spoke openly and in secret, didn't say anything, were very clear in everything. He said he can do nothing always of his own. In verse John 5:30, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, but the will of the Father which has sent me. Jesus directly stated that all power were given to him. Very important, MBI, understand that it was given to him. It is not his. Verse Matthew 28:18. Matthew 28:18. And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Given. I can give you authority to drive my car. Is it your car? No, it is not your car. It is my car.